All right, what's going on? It's your boy Antonio Johnson here with you again. I'm so glad to be here with you. Now, this is very, very important what I'm about to say to you. So please get a piece of paper and take some notes. This I'm about to talk to you about is about the TPC chart. That stands for talk to, presented to, and closed. It's a sheet we use when we're inside of the store to help us to understand where the problem is, all right? It's very important that you use this, but it's also more important that you know how to use it. Now, think about people that fly jets and stuff, all right? When they fly jets, they get something called vertigo, right? And so when they come to themselves, they don't know where they are. What do you think they lean on to locate position of that jet? They go down to the systems, that system they use. That's what they trust. They don't try to use their own thing. All right. And when we're inside of these retail stores, trying our best to reach our goals, we have to know how to use a TPC chart. It is gold. And I'm going to tell you something. Even if you're a high roller and you don't really use your TPC chart, I'm sad for you, because you're going to become a glorified salesperson. You can't train people your personality. You can train them on a chart, and you can help people understand their problem, and it'll make them just as good as you are. But they can't follow a personality. So some people are really good, so they don't use a TPC chart. They just talk to a bunch of people, and they talk to a bunch of people, and they high roll all the time. But they don't have a team. They haven't trained anybody. The reason being, because they don't trust the TPC chart. But if you want to get somewhere, you want to become an effective trainer and an effective manager, learn how to use this TPC chart. It is bread and butter. It is the ticket. All right. Got to give a shout out to a guy named Mike Bangs, because he is the reason that I understand what I'm about to tell you. All right. Now, on that TPC chart, first of all, there's some rules to that TPC chart. Number one rule, law of averages. You have to talk to everyone. You have to maximize territory. You have to protect your attitude. Okay. You cannot prejudge. You cannot cherry pick. Okay. All of that stuff is like important and mandatory. But here's the most important one I'm about to say. I left it for last because it's everything. You got to have a sense of urgency. If you don't have a sense of urgency, if you're doing things that are not helping you talk to people, like walking around, picking something up, moving stuff on the table, doing stuff like that instead of talking to people, you're not going to have a sense of urgency for real. So you got to have those four things first. All right. There's one more qualification for a TPC chart. What that qualification is this. You have to at least close more than 10 people an hour. Okay. You really want to close 20 people, but at least a minimum of 10 closes an hour before you can even network with someone about the close. If you were there an hour and you only got 6 closes, you cannot network about closing. That is a rule. You cannot network about closing if you don't have at least 10 closes in an hour. Number one rule. Okay. Hope that makes sense to you. Now, what'll help you get to the 10 closes? You have to pretend someone told you they'd pay you $10,000 if you closed at least 20 people every hour, except an hour that you take a short effective break. And you have to track all of that. That's how you have to do it. The best way to do it is this. You got to go from person to person to person, and you can't remember a no. If a no bothers you, you're not having a sense of urgency. All right. I'm laying down some rules because these are important, because I'm about to teach you how to network with your TPC chart. Please get a pencil. Please get a piece of paper. this is serious. All right. Now, the T stands for talk to. The P stands for presented to. And the C stands for close. Now, remember all the rules. If you didn't follow the rules I told you in the beginning, you're not going to use this TPC chart effectively. Now, let's say you start using this TPC chart and you talk to everybody, right? First thing is this. You put the tally under the area where the person ended. If you said, hello, check this out, and they said, no, I don't have time, I'm busy, that tally goes under T for talk to. That's inside your intro and your short story. You didn't get a chance to go to presentation. Okay? If you get them to the presentation and you're stressing the deal and they say, no, I'm not interested, and they walk off, the tally goes under presented to. If you get to the close where you actually say to them, so, did you need 5 or 10 as gifts, or did you need to start with just the 2 for yourself? And they say no, or yes, doesn't matter, but we're going to focus on no. Get those no's out of the way. And they say no, then that goes in the close. That's where the tally goes. And you should keep up with this. Don't miss a mark, because when you get in trouble and you're not having success and you are not getting those yeses, because you should get 10% yeses. That's 10% of the closes. All right. So here we go. Let's go and break this down. All right. So if you have more tallies in the talk to, there is only 3 problems that you're having. You are either having problems in your C factors, you're either not smiling, you're not using your eye contact, or you don't have enthusiasm, okay? C factors, check that first. Number 2, you either don't have a sense of urgency, you are not moving fast enough, you're not using sense of urgency language, it's not in your body, you are around there looking at people, cherry picking probably, because you done make sure nobody hurt your feelings. But sense of urgency, you should be moving within each person within 10 seconds from the time you're finished talking to them. You should be talking to another person within 10 seconds. All right. Or it's robotic. You memorize the words in the pitch and it sounds like a script. And you don't sound natural. It's not like a conversation. That's a problem. Okay. So once you know that, you can get on the phone. If you've gone an hour and you haven't had anyone to say yes, and all your tallies are in that area, then you can call and network with someone and say, hey, all my tallies are in the talk to. I'm smiling, for example. I'm smiling. I'm doing all my C factors. I'm not robotic. I've done my pitch. Let them hear your pitch. Let them decide if you're robotic or not. And then if you're not robotic, then guess what it is? It's sense of urgency. You gotta move. You gotta get it done. That's your problem. Lean on that. Fix that. Okay? If your tallies are more in the presented to, then there's only 3 issues. You didn't kiss it. You didn't keep it short, simple. Okay? You're qualifying questions. That means you're not asking the right questions to build relationships. And when you ask questions, you do have to pause and listen so you can respond. That's important, all right? Or it's your tone, your monotone. In other words, there's no inflections in your voice. You're just going, it's not like, all right? So it's one of those 3 things. So if all your tallies are presented to, when you pick up the phone and call someone to network with, you can kind of tell them what the issue is, all right? That is important. Okay. Now you can call them and say, hey, got all my tallies and presented to, go through the same thing. I've tried this, this, and this. I think it's my qualifying questions. I'm not asking. So can you help me with some qualifying questions that I might can use with you? All right. And then you get those qualifications, and then you go and try that in the field. And if it doesn't work, then, you know, come back, use that TPC chart again. All right. If you get them to the close, which means you get to assume that sale, right? And then you, you know, ask them that, you know, and then assume that sale, right? Then that's the close. And if you're not getting any, but remember the rule, if you don't have at least 10 to 20 closes in that hour, you cannot add an hour, last hour to the hour now. You cannot add those together. You have to start all over. Each hour, count your closes separately. Don't count them together. Now, it's one of four things in the close, all right? If you got all tallies in close, no yeses, but you have more than 10 closes, which you should be trying to get 20. If you are not getting 20, you are not assuming, I mean, you're not having a sense of urgency. So it's here it is. Here are the one of four things. It's either you're not assuming the sale, you're not stressing the deal, you're not using fear of loss properly, or you are not indifferent. So what do you mean by not indifferent? Meaning you look like, please pick this up. Please pick this up. Or you're sounding somewhat salesy, like, I need you to get this. All right. That's what they mean by indifference. It can be in your body or it can be in the way you're saying things. Or now fear of loss, like, you know what fear of loss means? You're not showing them that they're going to miss out on something, right? If they don't do it right now, right? Assuming the sale, meaning it's hard for a lot of people to like assume that sale. It feels uncomfortable to them. But you got to ask them for it. You got to ask them for it. Got to ask them for that yes or no. And then the other one is stressing the deal. So if you go through all four of those and you notice that, okay, I've done this, then it's got to be this. Whichever one is left, that's the one you want to call and network about. You call and network about it. And then you tell them, I've got all my, you know, I got a bunch of closes. I got like 18 closes. No one's got it. I eliminated everything. I think it's my fear of loss. But the first thing you want to know is what are the rebuttals when it comes to a close? Because that's what the networker probably is going to ask you. How many closes did you get? Okay, what are you hearing? So if you hear the word like this, if you hear, oh, you know, I just don't have enough money, right? What would that be? Stress the deal. Right? Or people are saying, how long are you going to be here? I got to go talk to my mom. I'll be here on payday. What do you think that is? That's that fear of loss. So you need to network about fear of loss. Ask them to give you a way to stress fear of loss in your pitch. This is how you fix yourself. If you lean on it like this, you will never go wrong. I would never go into a store without a TPC chart. The answer is there. Lean on those systems to solve your problems. Stop blaming the club. Stop blaming the customer. Blame the systems. It's not mean customers. It's not a slow store. You are not leaning on your systems. I promise you, if you lean on that TPC chart, you will always have success out there in those retail stores. All right. My name is Antonio Johnson. If you have any questions, you can email me. AntonioJohnson@yahoo.com. I'm telling you, use that TPC chart. Not only is it going to help you train other people and get them to being rock stars, but it's going to make your life a lot more simpler. Learn to trust the simple terms that are used to help you out. It's only those things. There's nothing else. All right. We're going to get 90% no's. So a no is a no. Don't get caught up in that. Lean on those systems. Find out where the problem is and fix it. And I guarantee you, you're going to have much success. But make it easier for the person you're networking with. Figure out your issue so when you call them, you can ask them to help you in that area. Because if you're doing what the TPC chart says, what I just told you, you're going to know where your problem is. All right? A networker will just be able to help you. So they don't give you some kind of blanket answer, some cookie cutter response. Take control. I'm telling you, it's going to make a difference. All right. That's it. Peace.